Trust in the trusted computing base is going to come from a number of things we expect it to do. We talked about design principles for secure systems. And this system is something that, you know, everything relies on it. So it better be secure to the degree possible. So it should be using some of those design principles. So let's go back and review a number of those design principles that we talked in general for secure systems, but we're going to see that they also apply to the trusted computing base. One of the design principles was least privilege. Anytime you're executing, the idea is that you execute with the fewest possible privileges. And idea is that if, you know, something goes wrong, so remember, trustworthy means that, you know, there's a high likelihood that things go the way you want them to, but there's no guarantee. Okay? There's no proof, as we said. So if something were to go wrong, of course, we have damage containment. The fewest things will be affected because, you know, what can be affected is what resources can be abused is based on what privileges you hold at the time. So holding as few as you need for doing what you're doing at the time, you want to use that principle even when you design the trusted computing base. Economy is the other thing. Economy is, we also said, keep it simple. It's really more important when it comes to trusted code. You want to keep it simple and as small as possible. The other design principle, and we're going to look at a couple of these, is open design. The idea is that trust is not going to come because somebody tells you, take my word for it. We're not going to have trust or confidence when security is by obscurity. We don't know how something is done, but we basically have to take someone's word for it. That's not a good way to design a trusted computing system. You do want to have an open design. So security is because you understand exactly how that level of security is being accomplished or achieved. We definitely want complete mediation. And that means that every access, right, that's one of the basic requirements for a trusted computing base, that every access is checked. Any attempt to bypass the system to go to a resource that needs to be secured, of course, is going to be prevented. So we want complete mediation. If that's not there, then of course, you will have no trust in the trusted computing base. We also talked about other design principles. Failsafe defaults is the default, you know, is gives you safe behavior. So when it comes to access control, the default should be deny. And finally, ease of use or psychological acceptability. Basically, we have to make the right assumptions about what users are able to do and what they're not able to do. If we make sort of assumptions about users that are unreasonable, they're going to avoid security that gets in their way. They're going to find ways to work around it, and that's going to result in lower level of trust. So I decided to sort of revisit these design principles. One of the things we're talking about here is the trusted computing base and where trust comes from. Well, if it's designed with the design principles in mind, the number of those that we have discussed here, of course, that's a question you're going to ask. And if somebody answers in the affirmative saying, yes, we follow those principles, that's a good thing.